Hello, dear love. I am Nicole, and this is the eve of our Sagittarius full moon. And I just wanted to come to you very quickly and explain to you the significance in this Sagittarius full moon. Now, I've already reached my boiling point on several different levels, and so have clients, and some of you beautiful spiritual superstars have commented on different videos, especially the Sagittarius full moon video that we have out there. I am coming to you live on Facebook tomorrow at 9 o'clock because our full moon tomorrow is fully illumined on the east coast of the United States at 9:09 a.m. The reason this is so significant is because the spiritual meaning to the number 9 is a culmination. It is saying, fear not, that you have all the spiritual resources needed to achieve a successful outcome. Give your energy to faith and not to worry. 9 is the ending and beginning of a career transition, a romance, a level of commitment, relationship, a physical move, health condition, and phase of life that you are having to release and let go of. The spiritual meaning to the number 9 is bringing you an energy that says spirit requests you to give it back to the universe and allow divine source to wash away the fear of the transition you are experiencing. So 9 is aligned to Archangel Raziel and Archangel Azrael for support and spiritual guidance as you close one chapter and begin the next in your beautiful book of life. Now, I absolutely encourage you to go to NicoleXO.com. I'll put the link right there and look at the rest of the meaning to the spiritual number 9. So tomorrow I will be on Facebook Live and subsequently 2 days thereafter. And we'll do the same thing 2 days before the Cancer New Moon and 2 days after the Cancer New Moon is fully illumined. This is a full moon right now that we're experiencing a powerful relationship dysfunctional energy, and it's surfacing through neighbors, spouses, siblings, parents, children, people at the checkout store. But absolutely, this is where you are not feeling valued, where there is energy that needs to be healed with in your relationship with another. It's coming. Now you're starting to see where you have not valued someone else and how appreciated you feel for their love, for how they value you. You are starting to see where you may have been looking for approval where you don't need to. You may see where you have given your power away, where you can take your power back. You may see how your energy is in need of healing, where you aren't valuing yourself. There's so many different energies within this theme of a relationship dysfunction, that imbalance in relationship that is asking for you to throw it up and get it out of your system the way that you have to. Sometimes it's going to be through an argument. Sometimes it's going to be through that breakdown moment of crying. Sometimes it's going to be through that moment of, I just need to be alone. Spirit has gifted us with the spiritual guidance for the week to be reminded to move with love. to confront our shadow side, break that pattern, and be heart-centered in our action forward. That is our healing, that is our power, and that is our spiritual guidance. I encourage you to view our weekly spiritual guidance where you will see that assertiveness is the way to go now. And it is not aggression, okay? Not the arguing, fussing, and fighting, breaking anyone's windows out, threatening, and all that ultimatum stuff is not the way. It's assertiveness, and it's not hemming and hawing and acting upset and saying you're okay when you're really not, and just looking angry but not saying a word of how you feel. It's not passive aggression either. It's assertiveness. So again, we've got the full moon happening on the East Coast in full illumination tomorrow, June 9th at 9:09 a.m. When you put those nines together, you can even reverse the number 6 for June and it looks like a number 9. When you put the ninth day, the ninth hour, 9 minutes past the hour, you add that up, you get 27. When you reduce that, you get 2 plus 7. And when you boil it all down, it's 9. This is a tremendously powerful full moon. I can't say it enough. I look forward to speaking with you and sharing with you how I've reached my boiling point and how I needed to assert myself and how difficult it was in some of the cases that happened this week. And I'm going to share with you some testimonies that have been emailed to me and that we've discussed in our private coaching sessions as well. Won't name any names because your confidentiality is extremely important to me. And I know what it takes to trust people, and I'm right there with you. So definitely thank you so much for giving me permission, for those of you who have, to share what has transpired in your life this week and what has been how you've really handled it and how you are handling it. Remember, when we're sitting with that energy, it's very vulnerable to do that. But in that moment of vulnerability, you are honoring your truth. And you're rising up to karma, and karma says you've had enough of doing it this one way, and now the door is open for you to do it a new way successfully and walk in that blessed opening for change. Dear loves, I will see you tomorrow on Facebook Live. The link is down below in the description box. And if you don't see it, it is Spiritual Guidance from Nicole on Facebook. And I'll see you at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to bring in the full illumination of the Sagittarius full moon in together. Now, I should say that it's not all doom and gloom, but it is absolutely uncovering where your relationships are dysfunctional. And it's asking us to take this energy to heal. But this is Sagittarius. This is the archer. This is hope. This is many blessings. Jupiter is direct. Jupiter is Zeus. Our good fortune, good luck. When Jupiter's in your sign, you've got 1,001 different opportunities right there for the taking, for you to just grab it. And so the hope is there, the love is there, but the value is there. If it's not worthy of your time and energy, then this is the time when Spirit is saying, I'm giving you the gift of being able to let it go. Doesn't come that easily because you've got to sit with that energy and it takes vulnerability. But through that, you do receive that blessed outcome of healing. Take great care. And I'll see you tomorrow morning on Facebook Live. Love you.